Number 10. Some of them actually look like lions. You might look at a sea lion and wonder where the name comes from. After all, the comparison between sea lions and terrestrial lions is less obvious than the one between seahorses and terrestrial horses. Sea lions belong to a group known as pinnipeds, which are commonly called seals. Pinnipeds are defined as a widely distributed and diverse clad of carnivorous, fin-footed, semi-aquatic, mostly marine mammals. Examples include sea lions, walruses, and elephant seals. The comparison with terrestrial lions begins when you consider that all sea lions are carnivorous as well, with large canine teeth or fangs. They also have a muzzle full of stiff whiskers and also make loud roaring noises. But then a particular species of sea lion, the South American sea lion, has a highly visible shaggy mane that covers their head and extends to their necks. The mane is most obvious when the hair is dry. When wet, it clings to their skin. Sea lions of different species have different dimensions. Take the California sea lion. The average weight of the male comes in at 660 pounds, and that of females comes in at 220 pounds. And for their sizes, males are about 8 feet long, and females are about 6 feet long. Number 9. Sea lions are mammals. This is another fact about sea lions which their name hints at. After all, terrestrial lions are mammals too. Sea lions, and all other pinnipeds, are warm-blooded vertebrates that have fur, give birth to live young, and breastfeed them. As aquatic mammals, they still need to breathe, and as such, they have developed special adaptations for that. Oxygen depletion and carbon dioxide accumulation limits how much time these creatures can stay submerged, although the time limit is more on oxygen than on carbon dioxide. After a sea lion returns from a long dive, carbon dioxide does not expire as fast as oxygen is replenished in the blood due to unloading complications with carbon dioxide. However, unlike terrestrial mammals, sea lions have a higher tolerance for carbon dioxide in their blood. Another adaptation sea lions have for living beneath the surface is that they can slow down their heart rate. This slows down all metabolic processes and conserves oxygen, which is a fuel for these metabolic processes. Similar to this, sea lions can reduce their digestion rate as well. Number 8. Sea lions are classified as eared seals. As mentioned earlier, sea lions are pinnipeds. Pinniped actually means flipper feet or feather feet. There are many different animals that are included in this group. However, these animals can be separated into two different groups, true seals and eared seals. There are 7 species of sea lions and 9 species of fur seals that make up the eared seals. Other than having external ears, sea lions differ from true seals in that they have large, more powerful forelimbs and can rotate their hind limbs forward and beneath them. This ability of theirs comes down to an altered skeletal structure. This skeletal difference allows the sea lion to sit in a semi-upright position. It allows them to walk and even run on all fours. Other than movement and posture, this skeletal difference also means that eared seals swim differently than true seals. True seals get most of their propulsion from their fused, tail-like rear flippers and undulating motions. They swim similar to dolphins. On the other hand, sea lions use their strong front flippers as big, highly effective oars, appearing to fly through the water like birds. Number 7. Sea lions are really noisy. The comparison between sea lions and terrestrial lions doesn't just have to do with appearances. Sea lions are just as noisy as their terrestrial counterparts. Although sea lions do not make a wide range of sounds, they almost never shut up. And since they like to move together, in groups, the combined loud noises can be quite a cacophony. They even make noises while they sleep. The noises sea lions make include grunts, groans, snores, barks, and roars. In spite of all this noise, their systems of communication aren't that well developed. Sure, they may argue now and then about the possession of prime basking areas, but the arguments are never meaningfully resolved, and sooner or later they all end up clumped up in the same spot. Sea lions also like to make noises just to feel comfortable. Though their social dynamics aren't well developed, they appear to have an innate need to be in close contact with each other. And so, by making noises, they can make another feel comfortable. Number 6. Sea lion whiskers are very sensitive. All animals have dedicated structures and appendages for enhanced sensitivity. For sea lions, those structures are their whiskers. Their hands and feet are dedicated to swimming, and so their whiskers, in conjunction with their nose and mouths, help them find and feel their way around things. Most mammals, other than humans, have facial whiskers which, when cut in cross-section, are circular. Sea lions are the exception in this regard, since their facial whiskers have an oval cross-section. This shape allows the whiskers to reduce self-vibration and focus on other important stimuli. More technically known as vibrissae, each whisker is connected to a large network of nerves, increasing their sensitivity. For this reason, sea lions can pick up very tiny disturbances in air and water. Much like humans use their fingers for touch, sea lions can sweep their whiskers over objects to feel their size, shape, and texture. And so, their whisker sensitivity makes them quite potent hunters. In detail, they use these whiskers to forage through coral, allowing them to sort between food sources such as assorted invertebrates, crabs, and their favorite food, squid. Number 5. They exhibit significant sexual dimorphism. We've discussed sexual dimorphism on this channel before. As a quick refresher, it is a phenomenon in which there are marked differences between male and female members of the same species. It usually occurs due to different anatomical, physiological, and behavioral needs and instincts between males and females. And sea lions are some of the creatures in which this characteristic is very visible. Male sea lions, who weigh the same as 60 combined bowling balls, can be as much as 4 times the size of females. Mature males also have impressive crested foreheads and massive necks. All these physical differences have to do with finding a mate. Males use their size to get prime breeding sites. Males sexually mature at about 10 years old. Before the females are ready for them, they go to breeding grounds on a small island or a beach known as a rookery. Large males fight off other males who try to get into their territory. If they fail, they just have to give it up. When the females arrive, weeks later, the males try to attract them in their territory and gather a harem of as many as 15 females. Number 4. Sea lions stay away from the North Atlantic Ocean. Sea lions are widely distributed all across the world, from Mexico to Australia. However, they tend to stay away from the North Atlantic Ocean. There's no clear scientific reason for this either. After all, the North Atlantic Ocean is at its preferable living temperature, and there's lots of food they can choose from. A reasonable hypothesis about this distribution pattern has to do with where these creatures evolved. Because they do not migrate large distances, this may be why they have yet to conquer the North Atlantic. Males of certain species do migrate in the winter to feed, although this takes place across very short distances. However, females and young of that same species do not migrate at all. Because males are much larger than the females and the young, they have much more demanding feeding requirements. And this is what necessitates their brief periods of migration. Again, because food is hard to come by in the winter months, they need to leave to hunt elsewhere lest they compromise the child-caring females and the young. They look for squids, clams, fish, and anchovies. Number 3. Sea lions have impressive cognitive functions. Sea lions are very intelligent and display much of the characteristics we associate with humans. For example, they are some of the only animals capable of bobbing their heads along with a piece of music. They are also very quick to learn new behaviors, which is why they are so common to see in zoos and aquarium displays. They have been demonstrated as being able to understand a kind of sign language. Some of the tricks sea lions have been taught as a result of this intelligence includes throwing and catching balls on their noses, running up ladders, or honking horns in a musical fashion. They are usually rewarded with fish by trainers for the completion of these tasks. Their intelligence isn't just used for recreational purposes, though. They are also used by the US Navy in military applications. Some of their functions include detecting naval mines and enemy divers. They can also trap enemy invaders in seconds before the enemy even knows what has happened. Number 2. Sea lions are really good swimmers. Sea lions are excellent swimmers. Some are born as natural swimmers, while other species wait a couple of weeks before they step into the water. Since parenting is a role that both males and females play, most pups learn how to swim from their fathers. They also protect them from predators while they are learning to swim. Sea lions are free divers and can dive at a depth of up to 984 feet in search of food. They can also hold their breaths for up to 20 minutes at a time. In addition to this, they can swim in quick bursts of up to 25 miles per hour. However, their average speeds are at about 11 miles per hour. Number 1. Sea lions have a built-in heating and cooling system. Being warm-blooded, most mammals need to keep their bodies warm. This allows them to continue their metabolic processes without dying. And so, although sea lions can dive deep into the ocean, where it is very cold, they still have a way of keeping their body temperatures at normal levels. And when it gets too hot, they also have a way of keeping their temperature cool, as excess heat is also bad for them. This system of body temperature regulation involves their flippers. When it's cold, blood vessels in the flippers constrict, and when it's warm, blood circulates to help keep the sea lion cool. Seals usually require cool, nutrient-rich waters with temperatures lower than 68 degrees Fahrenheit. Even those that live in warm or tropical climates live in areas that become cold and nutrient-rich due to current patterns. What is your favorite sea lion's fact of this list? Let us know in the comments section below.